Hey everybody, my name is David Barnes. I'm part of the Emerging Technologies Group at IBM. And in this video, I would like to give you a very quick updated overview and a demonstration of IBM Bluemix. I say updated because I've created videos like this in the past, but everything is moving so quickly, I thought it was time for a refresh. If you've seen any of my previous videos, I'm still going to cover the basics of Bluemix, but I will show a lot of cool new things along the way. And if this is your first time seeing Bluemix, I should cover a few of the basics before I jump into the demonstration, such as, what is Bluemix? Well, Bluemix is IBM's cloud platform as a service and more. It lets you quickly create, deploy, and manage your applications in the cloud, and you don't have to deal with any of the underlying infrastructure, and you don't have to deal with the hosting and the managing of your cloud-based applications. You can use the tools and languages of your choice. It comes with a catalog full of awesome services from IBM and from third parties, services that you can use in your applications. You can scale your applications with literally a couple clicks, and I'll show you that. And I think one of the greatest things is Bluemix has become an awesome platform to help you build out your hybrid cloud computing environment. So, all of that said, a demo is worth a thousand words. So I'm going to switch roles here. I'll change tabs, and I am David Barnes, software developer for Madeline Hotel and Resort. A business unit comes to me and they say, hey David, can you create an application for us so that our customers can go to our contacts page and chat directly with our customer service reps? And I'm like, yeah, no problem, I can do that. And then they say, oh, and can you have it by tomorrow? And in my head, I'm going, what? But to them, I say, yeah, I can do that. So I come over here to Bluemix. Now, I am logged on right now as a trial user. Anybody can go to bluemix.net, create a free trial account, and you can do everything that I'm going to do here. I'm going to click in the upper right-hand corner on that little head. That's what I call it, the head icon. I'll drop that down. You'll notice that I am connected to the US South Data Center. If I selected here, everything I do from this point on, I would do in the Sydney Data Center. Same thing with the United Kingdom. We have, I think, 46 cloud data centers around the world. Bluemix is running on these three now, and it's rolling out on more as I speak. A little while from now, I'll tell you how you can get Bluemix on any of our data centers. Very cool new stuff. So, to build my application, I'm going to go over to my dashboard. This is where I essentially keep my stuff, the stuff that I'm working on. And I'm going to build out this application. I'll click on the eye icon in the upper right-hand corner. And I want to point out right now that my friend Ryan Baxter created this app. I just altered it a little bit to fit my needs. Ryan used, I'll call it the Cloud Foundry approach. The platform as a service approach. In other words, he wanted to build the app, or he built the app using Node as his runtime and Redis as his in-memory data store. So he chose this approach where you choose your runtime, you choose your services, and then you push your code up into Bluemix. But if that's not the way you want to deploy your applications, you can use IBM containers, which supports Docker containers. And you can also use OpenStack virtual machines. I'm going to choose the Cloud Foundry approach. And by the way, if I seem out of breath and I go very quickly, it's because at the corner gas station, energy drink was on sale, 2 for $4. I had $8, so I'm cranked. So I'm going to go create an application. I want to create a web application. Here I can choose, do I want Java, Node, Go, PHP, Python, Ruby, ASP.NET, or I can bring in build packs from the open source community because Cloud Foundry, which Bluemix is built on, is built in an open source, I should say, it is an open source platform. I'm going to choose, let's see, Node. I'm going to say continue, give the application a name. I'll call this customer chat app. Click finish and that's it. Now Bluemix is creating an instance of Node and in just a moment, it'll be up on the web and ready for me to use. I mentioned that I also want Redis. So I'm going to go back over here to my dashboard, scroll down a little bit. Redis is a service, and by the way, there's my app starting up, my runtime. I'll choose Use Services or APIs, and this takes me to the catalog of really cool stuff for developers to use. Let me start down here at the very bottom with Internet of Things. If you want to build out an Internet of Things application and you don't want to build out an Internet of Things infrastructure, you can use these services and this foundation. And the guys that I work with, they have built out applications that fly drones and take photos, all using that foundation. Other things I want to point out here, let's see, data and analytics. If you need to build out a big data application or analytics application, there are services here for Apache Spark, Hadoop, analytics for Apache Hadoop. I'll scroll down here. There are insights for Twitter, insights for weather. The list goes on. Integration, very important. The things that I do here on Bluemix, they're not just stuck on Bluemix. We know that everybody is not just going to move their stuff up into a public cloud. That's why the word hybrid. So with these integration services, you can use secured APIs to go back into your enterprise systems. Web and application is a great place to point out. I said IBM services and third-party services. Here, the IBM services are in blue, and the third-party services, let's see over here. There's Box, there is Dreamface. I'll scroll down, there's SendGrid. Those are third-party services, but you use them the same way. And then the last thing I have to point out, because it is one of the hottest things going on right now, are the Watson services. Let's see. Concept expansion, concept insights, speech to text, text to speech, visual recognition. That's one my son's really getting into right now. There's personality insights, and I started to think about this. If you're in the dating game and you want to find out if that person's right for you, build an app with personality insights and check them out. And if they end up not being the right person for you, you can use relationship extraction. That's really not what those are for, but hey, if you are a creative software developer, who knows, maybe you can make something. So for me, I want to use a Redis service. So I'm going to go to the search bar, type in Redis. There's the service. I click on it. It takes me in and says, okay, what do you want to name your service? I'm going to name mine here Redis Chat. I will select the 30 megabyte version that's available in the free trial. When I select it, I say create, and that's it. Now Bluemix is creating the Redis service. So the node is already up and running, instance. The Redis service will be up and running soon. Wow, fast, right? And software developers are going, hey, but wait a minute, I still have to write my code. That's the point. You don't have to spend your time doing this. You spend your time creating fantastic applications. That's what you do, right? So I'll go back over to the dashboard here, scroll down. I can see that the chat app is up and running. The Redis chat service is up and running. And now I'm ready to go and deploy my code. Well, you have several different choices. Actually, you have an unlimited amount of choices on how you want to deal with writing your code and deploying your code. So I'm going to click up here. This is IBM DevOps Services. I'm going to hit refresh on this page. I already uploaded this code in advance of the demo. I told it the name of the app was going to be customer-chat-app. When I refreshed the page, it just went to Bluemix and said, hey, this app is running. Here's my code. I click on the deploy button, and that's it. It's taking my code, pushing it up into that node instance, and it'll be running in a moment. If that's not the way you want to do things, I'm going to switch screens here. If you are an Eclipse developer, there's a plugin for Eclipse. You'll notice I installed it. It already knows that that customer-chat-app is there, so I can push my code directly from Eclipse up into Bluemix. And if that is not to your liking, I'm going to switch over here to the trusty command line. Now, why would I want to use command line? Well, because my father used command line and his father before him, and by gosh, I'm going to use command line. Actually, it's because you can deploy any code on your system using the command line. In fact, if I do CF, I'm already logged in to Cloud Foundry. CFA, it says, okay, hey, there's your customer chat app. It's in red right now because it's restaging the application. I'm going to do LS. There's the code on my hard disk. So if I did CF push, all of the code in that directory and my manifest and all that stuff, I would push up into Bluemix so you can use whatever development tool you want. Let's switch back over here. I'll switch back into this. It's checking the status right now. Good timing. It just finished the deployment to that app. I go back over to Bluemix. I'll refresh the page here, and we'll see that the application is started and it's running and available in Bluemix. I'll scroll down a little bit. There it is. Click on it, and there's the URL, customer-chat-app.mybluemix.net. One more time. customer-chat-app.mybluemix.net. You can change that domain name and URL very easily. If I click on it, then I deploy my application. It's up and running. As the software developer for Madeline Hotel and Resort, I'm going to go back over here. Now, I already embedded a space in my page for that. I'll go down to the contacts page here. In the right side, you can see there's the application. It says, what's your name? G-E-O-R-G-E, Clooney, if I spell that correctly. And by the way, if you're ever using a chat, a customer chat, and you want really good response, tell them you're George Clooney. I say, I want to send. That's it. It says, hi, George, how can I help you? My app is up and running. Fantastic. And by the way, Ryan created this in about 4 hours. And I've practiced, and I can deploy it in 15 minutes. That's incredible. I go back to the business user, and I say, hey, here it is. This is fantastic. I expect them to buy me drinks. And instead, they come back, and they say, hey, here's a red stapler as a gift from us. Typical, right? So that's it. I created the app. I deployed the application. Now I want to scale the application. Down here, I click on more instances. I click on more memory, I hit save, and I deploy the application, or I should say I create more instances of the application. I scale it out. You'll notice that I'm available memory, minus 640. I went over my available memory because I'm using the trial account. I have a limited amount on my IBM account. I just crank that baby up because I get it free, right? Let me hit reset on that. I'm gonna go back over here to this main page. I want to touch on one more really important thing. I'm going to scroll down here, and let's get to it about right here. What I showed you just now, that is Bluemix running on a public version. You'll see here that there's Bluemix Public. It runs on our SoftLayer data centers. It's a multi-tenant environment. Anybody can go there. You might say, ooh, hey, I love this approach, but my business can't do that. We have security and compliance rules that just prohibit it. That's why we have Bluemix Dedicated, which can run on any of our SoftLayer data centers, but it's a single tenant Bluemix just for you, totally isolated. And if that doesn't fit your needs, we've got Bluemix Local, which runs in your data center. And you can mix them up. You can have some running here, some running there, use secured APIs, use external cloud services. As I said, this is the ultimate in a hybrid cloud computing environment. There is so much more to Bluemix than I can touch in a demonstration like this. What I recommend, go out to bluemix.net, create a free trial account, and see just how quickly you can create applications in the cloud.